coordinate you. What the hell happened in there? Batman! What happened?
Hi guys, and welcome to my first episode of Legacy of Lame. As you can probably tell from the title of this video, I'm going to be talking about prequels. That are pretty much pointless and have practically have nothing to do with the sequels or are barely connected to the series. But don't be mistaken, just because I say they are pointless, it doesn't mean I don't like them. Minus one or two that appear on this video, which I despise more than Little House on the Prairie, these prequels can sometimes be connected by either character or title, or, only for example, Prometheus. Now as you can probably tell, I don't like Prometheus. It's pointless, boring and unrealistic. In certain ways. I don't mean unrealistic as in aliens and synthetics, I mean unrealistic with plot points. Prometheus is basically a prequel to the Alien series created by Ridley Scott, which I do enjoy. My personal favourite from the series is Aliens, which was done by James Cameron, and is a brilliant film. The original Alien is alright, but personally they could have done it better, apart from this scene. This scene is perfect. Probably the biggest plot point in Prometheus is when the guy with the maps gets lost on the alien spaceship. Another specific plot problem is when the main character, Elizabeth Shaw, or should I say Ripley II, has a C-section in a machine built for a man, has her stomach stapled up and is therefore in severe pain, and then later in the movie she's sprinting about the place faster than Usain Bolt and Barry Allen put together. Overall, Prometheus is a pretty pointless prequel, and is hardly affiliated with the Alien series. Minus the odd synthetic and giant facehugger. I mean, even the stupid alien cameo at the end doesn't even look like the bloody xenomorphs.
Now enough about Prometheus. Shall we move on to some more pointless prequels?
Twin Peaks, Fire Walk With Me. Unfortunately a pointless prequel, but overall a fantastic film. If you have ever seen Twin Peaks, you will know that it is centred around the murder of Laura Palmer, with many supernatural twists and turns, along the journey of solving who murdered her. The main problem with this prequel is that you must not watch it until you've seen the television series because it spoils major plots from the series, for example, Laura Palmer's murderer. If you've never seen Twin Peaks, I would suggest you watch the TV series, then watch the film if you're interested. If you're interested in weirdness and being rammed down your throat by the good old David Lynch, Fire Walk With Me is an enjoyable overall experience, but still a pointless prequel. Halo 3 ODST. The Thing 2011. Overall enjoyable, but more pointless than patterns on your grandma's panties. Crisis Core Final Fantasy 7. Enjoyable, but you already know how it ends. Kingdom Hearts 3 5 8.5 Days and Kingdom Hearts Recoded.
Who else do I have ice cream with?
Sega said prequel trailer? Oh! Asshole.
And Sega Sodes.
And you.
So yeah, if you're into your prequels and stuff, then by all means, buy them. I'm not going to stop you. So now if you'll excuse me, all this prequel talk, it's made me thirsty.
Oh.
Well, I guess that's it. Weird. Whoa! Portal 2.